everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Abraham, and I am a fourth year nursing student at the UCLA School of Nursing. And I am also a non-traditional student, and I transferred from Los Angeles Pierce College in Woodland Hills. So continuing this conversation on my transfer journey, I wanted to touch on how I paid for community college when I came back from the military. So first, I do want to caveat that I am a military veteran and I do qualify for the post 9/11 GI Bill, but I did not use the post 9/11 GI Bill, nor do I recommend using the post 9/11 GI Bill for community college. So in Los Angeles or in California, under LACCD, tuition is $46 per unit. So because it is $46 per unit for a 3-unit class, that is less than $150. First, I have to implore to everybody, fill out your FAFSA. No matter if you think you qualify, if you don't qualify, whatever it may be, you cannot even get information on financial aid if you don't first fill out that FAFSA. So the FAFSA is always open until like March of the year that it's due or whatever. And then even then, you can still do it later. You just have to like put in a, you just don't get priority is what it's called. But so the first thing that I did was fill out that FAFSA. So if you go to FAFSA.gov, it's a free application. There's a FAFSA.com that tries to sell you a service to fill out that FAFSA application, but the FAFSA is a free application. So just go to FAFSA.gov and fill out that free application, because you can't even figure out if you qualify for financial aid until you fill out the FAFSA. So first thing I did was fill out FAFSA. When I did that, I found out that I qualified for what was called at the time the Board of Governors waiver, or the Board of Governors fee waiver. Now it's called the California College Promise Grant. And so what this does is it doesn't give me any money, but it makes my tuition for the first 2 years at a community college zero, absolutely free. So that took care of the annual like $1,000 that I needed to pay for community college for the first 2 years. So I qualified for the BOG waiver. Now it's called the California College Promise Grant, but it's still the same thing. It covers tuition for the first 2 years at a community college, as long as you meet the certain requirements. So you can actually Google that. A second thing that I qualified for was the Pell Grant. So the Pell Grant gave me free money for educational purposes, right? That's what I use to buy textbooks. That's what I use for like buying materials on campus. So the Pell Grant ended up giving me, I think it was about $2,000 to $4,000 a year, something like that. But that ended up helping actually like pay for the materials for the books and stuff like that. The money is supposed to go towards educational purposes. I can't tell you what the educational purposes are. That's, you know, up to you. But then the third thing that I did to pay for my community college was have a full-time job. I know a lot of people come to community college with a job. But I was very strategic in which type of job that I chose. So I'm a military veteran, so I use something that kind of relates to the field. Even though I was a medic in the military, I had healthcare experience, but a healthcare clinic would require me to work a 9-to-5 schedule, which is the time that I would be at school. So I ended up actually choosing to work security. I used a WIA grant, so it's called the Workforce Improvement Act, something like that. You do it through the Office of Unemployment. You ask for this grant. The grant pays for you to get a certificate, right? And so I chose the certificate to be the security guard card. So going to an agency, I ended up doing their guard card classes. They gave me all the certificates that I needed. They even paid for my first uniform, my first set of like security gear that I needed. And it gave me a position where actually I could study at my post at night and still go to school full time. So I worked full time as a security guard for 3 years, as well as go to school full time. Another thing that actually helped later on is I talked about this with getting involved in the three things that I did for community college, was I actually became a paid tutor at the community college. So being a paid tutor, it was a little bit more than minimum wage. It was less than, 10 hours per week, but that also gave me a little bit of extra money on top of what I made with my full-time job. So I did three things. I got the Board of Governors waiver, so it made my tuition zero. I qualified for the Pell Grant. The Pell Grant gave me that money that helped me pay for materials such as books and other supplies that I needed on campus. And I had a full-time job. It was not by mean a very glamorous job. I worked as a security guard at the post, but that gave me the time that I can actually study. I can pull out my laptop when hours are quiet and I can work on papers or essays, do homework. And it paid me just enough that I, still qualified for financial aid. And then eventually I got an on-campus job as a tutor, but I kept my security job still. So do you have any tips or suggestions? What is a on-campus job, or what is a full-time job that you held while getting through community college? Just drop it in the comments, and I'd love to hear from you. If you have any other questions, I'm going to be continuing this series. So please drop a comment, drop a like, and subscribe if you want to hear more about the transfer journey. All right. Thank you very much. Out.